गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम. टुडे इन दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन आई एम टेकिंग द फ्यू टॉपिक्स ऑफ हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिज्म रिप्रोड्यूस ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड. टुडेज टॉपिक्स आर रिप्रोडक्शन, इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन एंड टाइप्स ऑफ असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. First of all, we will learn about the concept of reproduction. Like other processes of the body, reproduction is also a biological process. It is a process in which organism produces their own kind or offspring. In this process, there is creation of a DNA copy. Reproduction is one of the characteristic features of all living organisms. Now, question arises, why reproduction is necessary? Because it ensures the continuity of life and also helps in increasing the number of species. Sexual reproduction plays an important role in bringing about variations and evolution of new species. Let us see what are the different types of reproduction. Broadly, reproduction is classified under two major headings, that is asexual and sexual. So let us see the differences between asexual and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, single parent is involved, whereas in sexual reproduction, two parents of opposite sexes are required. In asexual reproduction, there is no production of sex cell, reproductive cell or gametes. But in sexual reproduction, there is production of sex cell, reproductive cell or gamete cell. In case of asexual reproduction, there is little or no variation. That is why they are called as clones. But in sexual reproduction, there is lot of variation is seen. In sexual reproduction, there is no fusion and fertilization, whereas in sexual reproduction, there is fusion and fertilization. Since in asexual reproduction, there is no formation of gametes, so no fusion and no fertilization takes place. But in sexual reproduction, there is fusion and fertilization takes place. Now, we will see about types of asexual reproduction. As we have seen that asexual reproduction is a type of reproduction in which new organisms are formed from a single parent without the involvement of gametes or reproductive cells. There are different types of asexual reproduction. The main types are fission, which may be binary or multiple, budding, spore formation, regeneration, fragmentation, vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. Vegetative propagation or vegetative production may be cutting, layering, grafting. So let us discuss one by one. First one is about fission. Fission is a type of asexual reproduction that takes place in unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium, bacteria, etc. Here, the parent body divides into two daughter cells. In this case, first division of nucleus, that is called as karyokinesis, and then division of cytoplasm, that is called as cytokinesis, takes place. So first the nucleus divide and then the cytoplasm divide. Fission may be binary or multiple. So first we will study about binary fission. Binary fission takes place during favorable situation. As the name indicates, binary means two. So here two organisms are formed from a single parent. For example, in case of amoeba, bacteria, paramecium, it is commonly seen. You may observe in the figure that how from one bacterial cell and from one amoeba, two daughter cells are formed in both the cases. Now it is about multiple fission. In case of multiple fission, the parent organism divides into many new organisms. As the name indicates, multiple. Multiple means many. This type of fission takes place during unfavorable situation. But you have seen that in case of binary fission, it takes place during favorable situations. Favorable situations means whenever the climatic condition suits the organism. And unfavorable situations means the climatic condition does not suit the organism. So during unfavorable situations, organisms develops a protective covering around it, and that protective covering is called as cyst. Inside the cyst, the nucleus divides and redivides mitotically. Each nucleus takes a little bit of cytoplasm and forms large number of daughter cells. As soon as the favorable situation comes, the cyst wall rupture, as a result of which daughter cells comes out and form new organism. It is seen in case of plasmodium. That is, this plasmodium produces 1000 cells at a time. The given figure shows about the multiple fission in plasmodium. You can see here the cyst wall, and inside the cyst wall the nucleus divides and redivides to form large number of nucleus. Second type of asexual reproduction is budding. In this case, a bulging appears on the body of organism due to repeated mitotic division in the cells. This lateral bulge is called bud. The bud further grows and develops into new organism. Finally, the bud get detached from the parent body, and whenever they detach, they grow as individual organism. Example of budding are seen in Hydra and yeast commonly. In yeast, chain of buds are also seen. Here in the given figure, it shows about the steps of budding in Hydra as well as yeast budding and also chain of buds in the yeast. Next method of asexual reproduction is by spore formation. Spore formation is commonly seen in fungi and bacteria. In case of fungus, a structure developed from the plant body which is called as a sporangium. Sporangium is balloon like structure present on the elongated structure, that is called as a sporangiophore. The nucleus in the sporangium divides and redivides. Each nucleus takes bit of cytoplasm and develops into a spore. When the sporangium get filled with spores, it exert pressure on the wall of sporangium. As a result, the wall of sporangium rupture to release spores. Spores finally, on getting suitable substratum, they germinate into new plant body, that is into new hypha. This is the figure of fungus rhizopus, that is bread mold, showing the formation of spores. Now it is about regeneration. Regeneration is the ability of an organism to replace its lost body part, or full organism is formed from the body parts of an organism. Example of regeneration are Hydra, Planaria, sponges and Spirogyra. But in a Spirogyra, regeneration is called as fragmentation. This is the figure showing regeneration in Hydra and regeneration in Planaria. You can see here that small pieces of organisms, from small pieces of organisms, complete organisms are formed in both the cases. Last one is about fragmentation, which is commonly seen in multicellular organisms like Spirogyra. Here the organisms breaks into smaller pieces on getting mature, and each pieces further grow into new individual. You can see in the given figure that from one Spirogyra to a Spirogyra are formed due to fragmentation. This is all about today's session. Thank you and have a nice day. For any doubts, please write your questions in comment section.